Tonight, Tara Levinsky of the United States attempts to soar to the pinnacle of the figure skating world and become the youngest world champion ever. But the reigning world champion has designs on that title as well. Michelle Kwan epitomizes elegance on ice. But recently, she's been melting under the Levinsky heat. She must compose herself for the year's most important skate. Nicole Bobek, her struggles have been many. Tonight comes her greatest challenge, skating despite the tragic death of her coach, the legendary Carla Fosse, just 48 hours ago. Tonight, Tara Levinsky of the United States attempts to soar to the pinnacle of the figure skating world and become the youngest world champion ever. But the reigning world champion has designs on that title as well. Michelle Kwan epitomizes elegance on ice. But recently, she's been melting under the Levinsky heat. She must compose herself for the year's most important skate. Nicole Bobek, her struggles have been many. Tonight comes her greatest challenge, skating despite the tragic death of her coach, the legendary Carla Fosse, just 48 hours ago. 3 women, 3 distinct stories. But will tonight be remembered for the arrival of the Elfin Princess? When you think of winter sports, you think of Switzerland. Most of the charming villages are only minutes away from some of the finest skiing in the world. But it's the figure skaters who have arrived in Lausanne this week. From the Mallet Ice Rink, welcome to the World Figure Skating Championships presented by MasterCard. Welcome, everybody. I'm Brett Musburger. If you were with us on Thursday evening for the men's free skate, you saw Elvis Stoiko soar to his third world title and become the first man to land a quadruple toe, triple toe combination at the World Championships. Stoiko was exultant in victory, a celebration that reverberated clear across Canada. Tonight, it's the ladies' free skate, and we could once again witness history as Tara Levinsky could become the youngest world champion ever at the age of 14. Here are the standings after the short program. Levinsky is in the perfect position. She controls her own destiny. She wins the free skate. She captures the gold medal. Michelle Kwan, however, is in a very difficult spot. Fourth after the short program, she will need help to retain her title. But remember, Stoiko was in fourth place going into the men's free skate, and he struck gold. Their American teammate, Nicole Bobek, is in eighth, and she battles on despite the sudden death of her legendary coach, Carlo Fosse. We'll have the ladies free skate a little bit later, but we turn our attention first to ice dancing. The free dance is the third and final phase of this lovely competition. And here were the standings after the original dance. Russian teams have dominated the dance, and Grichuk and Platov are in position for their fourth consecutive world title. U.S. national champions Elizabeth Puntsalin and Jared Swallow are in sixth place. Let's join my colleagues, Terry Gannon and Dick Button, as they called the competition last night.
Here at the World Figure Skating Championships, presented by MasterCard, we are getting ready for the championship free dance. It is worth 50% of the skaters' overall scores, and it lasts 4 minutes. And getting us underway, the four-time and reigning U.S. champions, Elizabeth Puntsalin and Jared Swallow, in sixth place after the original dance. Liz and Jared could stay there or move up. It would be their best finish ever at Worlds.
They have had extensive Latin ballroom training in the last year, working towards the effect of this dance. Difficult move. If you notice, they're not allowed to separate. They're not allowed to lift each other above the level of the head. None of the high-flying spins or jumps that we see in single skating or pair skating.
And Dick, besides those restrictions, skaters have already skated in the compulsory dances and the original dance. How does this free dance differ?
The dance is that they're freer to use whatever steps they wish, whatever ballroom dance steps, in any direction that they want to go in. They don't have to stick to a particular pattern. They can use music of their own choice, provided it has a definite dance rhythm. Judges are looking for is a dance ability between the two dancers. Closeness, changes of turns, a variety of steps, musical interpretation, a specific type of dance music that a couple can dance to. Not theatrical dancing, but social dancing. This lip, only up to the level of his shoulders. Maybe a little higher. If he gets up higher than his head, that's a no-no. But look at the deep edges here. The little turns, the very complicated steps. The hand-to-hand positions. This kind of move, a highlight in the program.
Put in perspective how impressive their sixth place is right now. They finished seventh a year ago, but you have to remember that Sophie Mugnot and Pascal Labanche did not compete last year. They were injured. And many people expected Puntsalan and Swallow to even drop to eighth place.
Now look at the speed that they have here. The turning steps. They have a wonderful feel for the rhythm, the Latin rhythm of this dance. That almost goes beyond the edge of what the rules permit. But really, in a sense, who cares? It's really entertaining dancing.
The four-time and reigning U.S. champions. Crowd loves them. Elizabeth Puntsalan and Jared Swallow will be back with their marks when we return.
Figure Skating Championships presented by MasterCard. This special edition of ABC's Wide World of Sports brought to you by MasterCard. MasterCard, the official card of the World Figure Skating Championships. AT&T, it's all within your reach. Merrill Lynch, for our clients, the difference is planning. The difference is Merrill Lynch. And a whole new Hyundai. Driving is believing.
We're back in Lausanne with the ice dancing competition. Elizabeth Puntsalan and Jared Swallow of the U.S. awaiting their marks.
And look at the speed that they have in this ice dance with these accents, these individual moves that are placed throughout the program to give highlights to it. And they certainly have an enormous amount of flair, as this very last move in the program demonstrates. I mean, really, that's a gorgeous position. Wonderful ice coverage, intricate patterns, very attractive dancing.
Puntsalan and Swallow making their fourth trip to the World Championships. They are a married couple. became a couple on the ice back in 1989, won a national championship in 1991, very short time. They were their coaches, Igor Spielman and Elizabeth Coates. And they had a fall in the original dance, which makes their performance even more impressive, Dick, because it really didn't hurt them at all. That's how much the judges thought of them. In the march for technical merit.
And very good ones, I must say. And very consistent. Look at how tightly spaced they are.
And the second set of marks will be for presentation. And those are very good as well. 5.6 up to 5.8, even better than the technical merit marks. So good night for Hunselin and Swallow.
Sur la glace, on the ice, Sophie Moniotte, Pascal Labanchy, France.
And here are Sophie Moniotte and Pascal Labanchy of France. They were the bronze medalists in 1995, did not compete last year in Edmonton because of Sophie's broken ankle. There are a lot of French fans here to support them.
And what they're skating is a gypsy folk dance. Dance, very commercial in the sense, very popular. It's easy to understand. It's tailored for the audience.
Pascal certainly used to success at the World Championships. A bronze in 95, a silver in 94. It was Sophie's broken ankle that kept them off the ice for 8 months last year.
But look at the speed that they have here, the very tricky turns. Very difficult. Very good speed. First three rules the judges look for are speed, speed, speed. Next and most important are the intricate and varied close dance holds.
Thank you.
They certainly have energy and attack this dance with great, great strength. I think that will reflect well in their presentation mark, the second mark that we'll see. Very powerful dance, very strong.
And a big reaction from this French crowd. We're not far from the border. A lot of fans here to support them. Sophie Magnotte and Pascal Lavancy in fourth place, hoping to stand on the podium. And remember, the top three dance teams are still to skate, including the reigning silver medalists, Grilova and Ovsyannikov. They take the ice next when we return to Lausanne. Welcome back, everyone, to the World Figure Skating Championships presented by MasterCard. The championship free dance continuing. You hear the reaction from this partisan French crowd, the technical merit marks from Magnotte and Lavancy.
And all very tightly spaced at that 5.7 level. Still room above for any other couple yet to come.
The second set of marks for presentation, and those are good enough to put them ahead of Ponsalin and Swallow in the first place among those that have skated already tonight.
5-8.
Thank you. Dans une semaine. Sur la glace, on the ice, Angelika Krylova, Oleg Ovsyannikov, Russia.
They are the reigning silver medalists. And in second place, Gushukin Platov after the original dance. Angelika Krylova and Oleg Ovsyannikov of Russia.
The music. Masquerade Waltz, Kachaturian. Remember, this is the story of a man who comes home from a waltz, finds his wife, and suspects his wife of being unfaithful. Not a traditional waltz, more of a modern variation. A very grand style, bold strokes.
Angelika and Oleg used to train with Gushukin Platov and certainly have chased them for some time. With Yevgeny Platov's injury this year, they thought maybe this was their year to win Europeans and the World Championships. Still may be, but they've had to look over their shoulders at Shailene Bourne and Victor Kratz of Canada, who are in third place. And they will come up a little bit later on.
Look at how the motion. The movements here slide into slow motion against the beat of the music. thing that they exceed at is speed. They move with great flair across the ice. Tremendously different, difficult positions, something specifically that the judges are looking for. And of course, in the end, he kills her.
Poisons her with ice cream, more specifically. Girova knocks Anikoff in second place, trying to win gold here in Lausanne. We will be back with more of the World Figure Skating Championship presented by MasterCard after this message and a word from our ABC station.
You're watching the World Figure Skating Championships presented by MasterCard.
Angelika Krylova and Oleg Ovchinnikov of Russia have never won a world title. It's in the hands of the judges right now.
And look at this slow motion. Look at the extensions that they get. And in this lift, note very carefully, she goes above his head, but his arms do not. One of the very intricate rules of ice dancing. A beautiful move.
When they left the ice, their reaction gave me the feeling that they feel like they skated this very, very well, not as well as they could have. Now we get the reaction of the judges for technical merit.
And you can see that they're very high. There's only two more skaters yet to come.
And for presentation, 5'8s and 5'9s, they are in first place at this point. However, on the ice next, their Russian world teammates, Oksana Grishuk and Yevgeny Platov, these two couples were once the best of friends. A lot has changed over the past year, both on and off the ice.
It's a little more than a year ago that these four ice dancers sought comfort and companionship in each other as they struggled with homesickness far from their native Russia. But just a year later, much has changed, and it is clear that the same common goal that brought these teams together is the one that separates them today. Their goal, to be the best ice dancers in the world.
I think it's nobody like to be all the time number two, but for now I think we must just don't think about it, what we number two, we number one.
Last year, such confidence might have seemed surprising, since Angelika and Oleg appeared almost comfortable with the idea of being second to Grishuk and Platov's first. And for both teams, remaining friends was as important as competing to win. But today, it's clear that training with different coaches in different cities has taken a toll on their friendship.
It's not possible to be a very good friend and be very close concurrents in the world and Olympics.
Because it's like big politics, you know?
Yes,
it's like same big politics, yeah.
You talk about friends, of course, it's sad when you came here and, you know, no friends, you should find some people, you know, you will talk with. But this is not what we're looking for. We're looking for a new place to work.
No longer dependent on the other team, these skaters find companionship in one another, as well as their coaches. But the distance has undoubtedly strengthened their rivalry. When Yevgeny and Oksana set out a number of competitions, Angelika and Oleg easily won gold. They had hoped to continue their winning streak at the European Championships, but Grishuk and Platov's stunning performance, which earned a total of 12 perfect scores, laid those hopes to rest and left no question as to who was number one. But despite the daunting competition, Angelika and Oleg are no longer content to stand in anyone's shadow. And both teams agree that the future cannot be told.
I don't really have this feeling that anybody can beat us at Worlds, honestly. But you never know what happened, because it's sport, anything can be happen.
Grishuk and Platov trying to hold off the charge of the friends they used to be very close to, Krylova and Ovchinnikov. Here they are trying to win their fourth consecutive world championship. Yes.
The music, a cool wind is blowing. One of the things that you want to look for in this dance is the extraordinarily difficult, intricate steps done with great speed and great security.
And they receive.
This pair is a master of their technique.
And they received six perfect sixes, Dick, for this free dance at the European Championships.
Look at this lift. Notice how close this is, how tight and deep those edges were. That's exactly what the judges are looking for.
They should win. They would become the first dance team to win four consecutive world titles since Bessianova and Bukin from 85 to 88.
Look at the depth of the technique here. Really extraordinary. They have the best speed, power, control, and balance. Any of the ice dancers in this championship. One thing, even though the moves are fast, there's nothing frantic about this dance. Very controlled. Wonderfully, wonderfully difficult. The fact that they missed the music at the end will hurt them. I'm sure will prevent them from getting the row of sixes that they got at the European Championship. But you know, I've seen them skate this program many a time, and almost always they have missed the end by a fraction of a beat.
Oksana Grishuk and Yevgeny Platov of Russia. Born in Kratz, still to skate, and technically they do have a chance to win. Stay with us. We're back in Lausanne following a powerful performance by Grishuk and Platov, the three-time and reigning world champions.
But look at this moment in their program. Watch as he sets her down. Her skate catches in her skirt. But it doesn't even disrupt the flow. I would be surprised if the judges didn't even notice that.
Well, you have to wonder about perfect sixes. None here for technical merit.
No, but look at the 5.6 from the U.S. judge and a 5.7 from the Austrian judge. Those are pretty low.
The presentation, two sixes on the board, and those marks good enough to place Grishuk and Platov ahead of Krylova and Ovsyannikov at the top. But it is not over yet. Shailin Bourne and Victor Krantz of Canada, the reigning Canadian champions.
The music, High Society Overture.
As in the other disciplines, if you are in the top three heading into the final portion of the competition and you win this portion, you're the overall champion.
Now look at the difference with this couple from Grishuk and Platov. Look at the fast, intricate footwork, but long, sweeping low edges. Very gentle kind of ice dance, as opposed to the power and the strength and the passion of Grishuk and Platov. Quite a different style of dancing. Look at the knees. Wonderful move.
Year ago in their home country, and if you think that upsets don't happen in the world of ice dancing, remember Grishuk and Platov themselves at the 94 Olympics.
Now look at how much more of a popular, romantic, modern dance than the very ethnic dance of Grishuk and Platov. Wonderful movement. Beautiful depth, beautiful low, soft, supple knees. There's a little hydroblading. I tell you, there's a popularity about this dance that's going to be very impressively received by this audience. How do you like that?
I see Lynn's mother, Peggy Skipper, in the audience. Smile on her face. Why not?
I'll tell you, for the first time, I had felt that Grishuk and Platov were challenged by this dance.
Remember, Krylova and Ovsyannikov in second place. Jaylen Bourne and Victor Kratz defeated them at the Champion Series final a couple weeks ago. We'll have their marks when we come back. Back here in Lausanne, Jaylen Bourne and Victor Kratz following their championship free skate.
And really a very beautiful dance. But an example of one of the elements of ice dancing that they began is this hydroblading. Very unusual and very difficult move. Quite wonderful, isn't it?
Now they have challenged Krylova and Ovsyannikov, who are in second place. And you mentioned you don't think Vashuk and Platov have been pressured this much in a long, long time, Dick. They lead.
Well, I highly doubt that they will defeat Vashuk and Platov, but I certainly think that the program was not as difficult or as technically demanding by any means. You can see the marks are lower here in technical merit.
And they anxiously await the second set of marks, which will tell the story. For presentation, there they are.
It was just a very pleasant dance. It was really beautiful to watch, enjoyable. The difficulty, not as great.
And they come up short and end up in third place. So Grishuk and Platov continue to dominate in the world of ice dancing. For the second straight year, Krylova and Ovsyannikov capture the silver. Bourne and Kratz again the bronze. And Puntsalan and Swallow, the best finish by an American couple since 1990. Right now, Leslie Visser is standing by with the Americans. Leslie?
Terry, it was their first standing ovation at the Worlds and well-deserved. Great job by both of you. Liz, to you first. Maybe people in America don't understand what sixth place is. Why is that impressive?
Well, it was great for us this year because we were ahead of two teams that we hadn't beaten before at any championships, let alone Worlds, so it was a big movement for us.
And what did you come here wanting to emphasize? What did you want to prove at these Worlds?
Well, improvement from last year, which is harder to do every time you show up for Worlds, and also we just wanted to make a big impression.
Well, that you did. And Jared, how do you think this sets you up for the Olympic Games?
It definitely shows the world that we're competitive in ice dancing. A United States couple in sixth place is great going into an Olympic year, and this is the confidence that you should have and that we now have, and it gives us a momentum, and it gives us a great shot at medals next year, I think.
Well, you have a lot of confidence and you have a lot of support. Congratulations to you. Thanks. Back to you, Terry.
Well, Oksana Grishuk and Yevgeny Platov can't take it to the next level. There isn't one. They become the first dance team to win four consecutive world titles since 88 and the seventh to do it overall. They join Leslie now.
Terry, I don't think Carl Lewis could keep up with these guys. They are so fast and so powerful. Oksana, congratulations to you. What happened there with your skirt?
I don't know. I used to skate in pants for the practice, and this is a new dress for this competition, and it was, I guess, a little bit too long. But it doesn't bother me.
No, it didn't seem to bother many people. You've won so many medals. What is the challenge for you skating now?
We're looking forward to compete on next Olympic Games in 98 next year, so that was a lot of pressure for us. It's a very important competition here.
And what do you think you did well this evening?
Yeah, we did very well, and we're happy with that, and, you know, just one mistake because it's skirt, but it's okay. You know, we didn't fail, and we skated really great tonight.
Yes, you did. Congratulations to you both. Back to you, Terry.
Leslie, up next, the championship ladies free skate with European champ Arina Slutskaya, 1995 U.S. champion Nicole Bobek, reigning world champion Michelle Kwan, and the leader after the short program, Tara Lipinski. That's after this message and a word from our ABC station.
The World Figure Skating Championships presented by MasterCard. This special edition of ABC's Wide World of Sports brought to you by MasterCard. MasterCard, the official card of the World Figure Skating Championships. Vaseline Intensive Care Dry Skin Formula, the science of healthy skin. A whole new Hyundai, driving is believing. And 100% Colombian Coffee, official sponsor of the World Figure Skating Championships.
At the age of 14, Sonia Henie became the youngest world champion, a record that has stood 70 years. Tonight, we are on the verge of history as the 14-year-old, 4'8", 75-pound frame of Tara Lipinski looms so very large. She's the leader after the short program, possesses talent beyond her years. But does she have the maturity to finish what she started? Following close behind are France's Vanessa Gasmaroli and Russia's Maria Butyrskaya. To win, they must overcome their history of inconsistency. The reigning champion now stands in fourth place. So far, we've seen glimpses of the old Michelle and the recent Michelle. Which Kwan will skate tonight? The ladies' final. It's come down to one skate. Will the Mighty Might beat history in Lausanne? Winter in the Swiss Alps is slowly dissolving into springtime in the valleys and villages. Every scene here is a picture postcard. This is a storybook country where tradition, culture, and nature have always lived in close harmony. And today, we come to you from Lausanne on the shores of Lake Geneva. This is a gracious, French-speaking city of 150,000. Welcome, everybody, to the Millet Ice Rink and ABC's continuing coverage of the World Figure Skating Championships presented by MasterCard. Welcome back, everybody, and the time has come now for our featured attraction, and that is the Ladies' Championship. All eyes certainly are on Tara Lipinski of Sugar Land, Texas, who has arrived at the Millet Ice Rink. Now, the cameraman who covered her arrival said she was very relaxed at her morning skate. It's interesting, she seems barely large enough to lug her luggage around the arena. And if you were with us on Wide World of Sports earlier, you know that Lipinski skated flawlessly in her short program. It is certainly worth a second look. And here's how Terry Gannon, Dick Button, and Peggy Fleming called that program.
You have to wonder how life could get any better. If Tara Lipinski, well, there's one way. She could walk away with a gold medal here in Lausanne.
Well, she has certainly stepped through the door that Michelle opened at Nationals, and it's a whole new world. Her music from the movie soundtrack, Little Women. How appropriate.
Lay back. Better than most, not good enough for her to be in the great category on that move. But that's sort of nitpicking, you know? She is such a wonderful all-around skater.
She certainly enjoys her skating.
Now, the combination that she may do could be one of the most difficult in the world of women's skating. First, a triple lutz. Double loop.
Is a triple flip, this footwork into it.
Part of that footwork is required.
Oh.
Such a tight revolution in the air.
It is.
Such a quick spin. Now watch this jump. This is the double axel. She has a tendency to spin off the edge, which means that she doesn't lead to it with a great deal of height in the first part of the jump. Right here, watch.
Yep.
But that tight rotation in the air saves her.
Perfectly done, except that it doesn't step up into it.
Boy, this young lady certainly knows how to keep her composure, her focus. Wow.
Last year at World, she was in 23rd place after mistakes in the short program. What a difference a year makes, especially when you're 14 years of age.
She was wonderful. She reminded a lot of us of a spinning top. And here are the standings for the ladies after the short program. She certainly controls her own destiny, win the free skate, and she's the champion. She's followed by France's Vanessa Kuzmaroli and Russia's Maria Butyrskaya. Now, in fourth place is the defending world champion, Michelle Kwan, so she needs some help. And you see that Irina Slutskaya is a disappointing sixth. Nicole Bobic is in eighth place. We mentioned Slutskaya being in sixth place. She was devastated after her short performance. She came into this competition one of the favorites, and then more devastation earlier today in practice. She crashed hard. A back injury. 45 minutes of medical attention. So we'll keep an eye on that story as it unfolds. And you know, there are many ways to measure the spectacular rise of Tara Lipinski over the last 12 months, but her performance in the short program here in Lausanne is perhaps the best example of how far she has come. A year ago, she was in 23rd place after the short program at the Worlds, and now she's in first. Terry Gannon, that's incredible.
Well, Brent, I guess nothing that Tara does should shock us anymore, but as remarkable as her rise has been, what about the fall of China's Chen Lu? After winning the world title in 1995 and holding the number two spot at this point last year, she found herself in 25th place after the short program didn't even qualify for tonight's free skate. Her season has been one of injury, rifts with her coach and the Chinese Federation, and now the worst experience of her career here in Lausanne. She may turn things around, but it will not be at these World Championships. Now, with regards to Lipinski, there is someone here who knows what it's like to be a very young champion, Peggy Fleming. Peggy, with Tara, she seems to be unfazed by all of these expectations. Is that the case?
Well, Tara's not totally innocent of pressure. Last year's World Championships was her first test. But this year, as the leader, she's expected to win the same way she did at Nationals. She has now officially entered the pressure cooker of world and Olympic favorites. We seem to be putting 14-year-old Tara Lipinski up on that same shaky pedestal that 16-year-old Michelle Kwan is struggling to remain on. But for the moment, Tara is protected by her innocence.
Well, Peggy, it is unbelievable that a year ago we were talking about Michelle Kwan as the third youngest ladies world champion in history. Now she's the veteran trying to hang on. Dick Button, how quickly things change, huh?
Well, it's kind of hard to remember that Michelle Kwan was Sweet 16 and is from Torrance, California. I mean, shouldn't she be spending her days at the local mall? Instead, she's reeling from being knocked off her pedestal, from having her once secure jumps fail her, from being prompted and promoted and petted and pushed. I mean, not that any of this is evil, it's just a lot. But enough of all this. This is the World Championships. No excuses allowed. What it comes down to is the triples. So forget that she's exquisite. Forget that this year, skating really makes me care. Don't think of beauty, think of jumps. That's where the battle is. The gladiatrices are facing the lions. Let the blood be drawn.
The leaders, including Michelle Kwan and Tara Lipinski, will skate in the final group of the evening. Here's a look at the order in which they will skate. They'll take the ice a little bit later. Coming up next, the group that includes the 1995 U.S. champion, Nicole Bobic, as the World Figure Skating Championships continue here on ABC's Wide World of Sports.
This World Figure Skating moment brought to you by Hyundai. Driving is believing. After falling three times and losing her national title earlier that year, America's Elaine Zayac incredibly landed six triple jumps at the 1982 World Championships. She overcame a fall in the short program and climbed from seventh place to the top of the podium.
A moment that she won't forget for the rest of her life.
Make sure you're with us Thursday evening at 8 o'clock, 7 Central Time, as our coverage continues of the World Figure Skating Championships presented by MasterCard. We'll have the special performances from this year's champions, gold medalists in all the disciplines. That begins at 8 o'clock, 7 Central Time, Thursday night on ABC's Wide World of Sports. Here at the World Figure Skating Championships presented by MasterCard, we are inside the Malle Ice Center. The ladies' championship free skate, and you're looking at Joanne Carter of Australia. She is a three-time Australian national champion and 16 years of age. There have been a number of surprises so far in the ladies' competition. Joanne would be one of them. This is her first trip to the World Championships. She's in 10th place.
Very nice opening triple loop jump.
That was intended to be a triple jump. As a double jump, it fails to give her the points she needs. Very nice pair of triple toe loops.
Championship free skate worth two-thirds of the overall score, and it lasts 4 minutes as opposed to 2 minutes and 40 seconds in the short program.
The thing to note about this skater is the security of her steps. She's very solid, the edging very strong.
Looks like she's skating very carefully, almost slow though. Was intended to be a triple salchow. She only did a double.
You mentioned this is her first trip to Worlds, and when you compare her 10th place finish in the short program with what Tara Lipinski did a year ago, being 15th overall after the free skate. It's very impressive that the 16-year-old is in the top 10 right now.
On that double axel.
I think she's glad to get that over with.
It's almost as if she's ignoring the music, isn't it?
Right.
The three-time Australian national champion hoping to stay in the top 10. Joanne Carter will have her marks when we return. Welcome back to Lausanne as 16-year-old Joanne Carter of Australia awaits her marks.
And look at this combination of moves that she does. First, a triple toe loop, very, very strong, straight and clean. And the second one, a little bit of lack of control on the landing. Good quality.
5-4, 5-0.
And here are the marks for Joanne Carter. There'll be two sets of marks, the first for technical merit. The range 4.8 up to 5.4. And now for presentation, the range 4.8 up to 5.4 once again.
Sur la glace, on the ice, Laetitia Hubert, France.
Here is 22-year-old Laetitia Hubert of France. Now, we are very close to the French border, and this is a partisan French crowd. She'll have a lot of support here in the Mallet Ice Center.
There's a lot of cowbells ringing here.
Yes, there are.
For good reason.
She's in seventh place after the short program.
Tuxedo Junction.
She's been skating very well on the practices, very consistent on her jumps. She may be attempting a triple-triple combination in this long program, but her first triple is a triple Lutz. Watching back. Very nice.
Now watch how smooth she is, how she takes her time. There's no flailing of arms here. Very clean. Simple skating.
This, of course, the first group of skaters that we will see tonight. Final group, including the overall leaders, Tara Lipinski, Michelle Kwan, Maria Butyrskaya, and more.
And now coming up, if she's going to do the triple-triple combination, it'll be here. And it almost happened. Interesting positions in the camel spin. Change back sit.
Triple loop jump, a single one. But notice right here now, change in music again. I think the multiple cuts in this music certainly weaken it. It's not a choreographic whole, a musical whole, and that doesn't help her.
Laetitia is no rookie. Went to her first World Championships back in 1991. Many people thought she'd retire this year because of injuries. She really hasn't competed internationally except for the European Championships, in which she placed 12th.
Music, of course, in the mood.
Good flow and good speed.
Yeah. did very well. She's very pleased with her performance.
Well, it's essentially a very clean program.
She only had three, you know, sort of small mistakes, but very well.
Big smile on the face of 22-year-old Leticia Hubert of France after a strong free skate here at the Mallet Ice Center. And when we come back, the 1995 world bronze medalist from the U.S., Nicole Bobek, as the World Figure Skating Championships presented by MasterCard come back after this message and a word from our ABC stations.
You're watching the World Figure Skating Championships presented by MasterCard.
Back here at the Mallet Ice Center in Lausanne, Switzerland, is Tisha Hubert of France awaiting her marks. In the first set for technical merit.
Those are quite high marks. She had a fair amount of technique in that program.
And now for presentation. And both sets ranging from 5.3 up to 5.6. She is the leader in terms of those that have already skated. An emotional 2 days for Nicole Bobek since the death of her coach, Carlo Fossi, on Thursday here in Lausanne. She's needed the support of Carlo's wife, Krista, and Olympic champion, Robin Cousins. Leslie Visser talked to her yesterday afternoon.
Carlo was like my dad. He took the place of my dad, and he just took me in his arms, and he was behind me no matter what.
Do you feel that in some ways that maybe you're at the World Championships because of him, and maybe he was here because of you?
I believe I made the Worlds because of him, and because he really helped me and pushed me and taught me everything and protected me from everything. And you know, he was so happy that he was here and seeing everyone and being able to bring me here. He was really proud of it. And I think maybe he's happy that maybe he passed away here instead of somewhere else.
Do you know this, what Carlo's last words were to Krista?
From what Krista told me, that before he went, his last words were to make sure that Krista's with me tomorrow when I compete.
And do you also feel that he will be with you?
Yes, I think he will be with me no matter what. So, I know he's there. I just can't see him.
And before this free skate, backstage, Nicole Bobek, much more upbeat, much more ready to step out onto the ice. She would love to have a great performance here.
The music, Giselle.
Well, Carlo helped Nicole reclaim her place on this world team, and now Nicole has to face this toughest event without him. Opening with a double axel. Good spring.
There's a far greater musicality about her this year. Much more disciplined and controlled. It's been a very impressive growing up time for her. Difficulty in order not to make mistakes.
It's been a very difficult event for Nicole.
I think she's gained a lot of admirers this week with how she's handled herself. And today, very composed, even though you know And she's also very emotional inside. It's okay, and she does have a chance to stand on the podium in eighth place after the short program.
Extension, first rate.
It's absolutely spectacular when she does her spirals.
Full saw cow.
Besides all that she has had to deal with this week, it is quite amazing that she has even made it to the World Championships. She was injured throughout the entire season. Strong performance at the U.S. National Championships to pull up from sixth after the short program, capture a bronze medal.
It's almost as if she's slowing down at the end, but the program is far more musical, far more controlled, far more complete than we've seen her do in the past years.
Well, it's very understandable that she doesn't have her usual spark and that drive and that aggressive spirit out here under the circumstances. She's still a very stunning figure to watch.
And you have to feel for her. How difficult the last few days must have been, and on her knees, obviously thinking about Carla. A prayer for her coach, Carlo Fossi, at the end of her free skate. Nicole Bobek of the United States and her U.S. teammate, the U.S. champion, the leader after the short program, Tara Lipinski, getting ready backstage. She will skate a little bit later on. Nicole Bobek along with Krista Fossi, Carlo's wife, and one of her coaches, and Robin Cousins, the 1980 Olympic gold medalist, who also was coached by Carlo Fossi. We tend to forget that these are teenagers out here, and she's getting support from both of them right now. Technical merit marks for Nicole.
Well, I think it says a lot about Nicole's strength of character that she even competed here at this championship.
And her marks for presentation.
On the ice, Yulia Lavrenchuk, Ukraine.
Here is 18-year-old Yulia Lavrenchuk of Ukraine, Ukrainian champion, who really surprised the skating world when she finished third after the bronze medal at this year's European Championships. A year ago in Edmonton, she finished 17th. So it's been quite a year for her.
So she's skating to the music of Malaguena.
One thing that she does have is great speed. Even if she is pumping her back up and down, she does get speed across the ice, And watch here, watch the pole vault reach. Practically no pole vault at all. No reach behind her. Revolution not complete. And there, of course, goes that jump.
Now watch this. This is an amazingly long setup for this next jump. Now watch, she just skates around the rink almost twice, preparing for this triple loop jump. More crossovers.
Here it comes. Here it comes.
And there it is.
And it was a nice one, too.
It was. It was worth waiting for, I guess.
I must say, to her credit, is that she has survived exceedingly difficult skating conditions in the Ukraine. The ice conditions there are almost non-existent. Viktor Petrenko has had terrible trouble in trying to help them. So that she can, when she can pull off a nice triple jump like that, she must be very encouraged.
Well, she told us that the one rink in which she skates and practices, the normal temperature is about 15 below. Maybe an exaggeration a little bit, but certainly tough conditions with which to train.
Not very inspiring. I think sometimes people are surprised that these skaters in cold conditions like that, you do get very, very warm because you're moving around and spending so much energy. It takes a lot of energy and endurance to pull off all of these moves.
And there was
and
a day
for 4 minutes
when these championships were held outside.
Right, I was at the last outdoor world championships in Vienna, 67.
I was at the first.
We're a study in contrast here. Nice triple salto. This combination spin, beautiful position in the layback, good speed.
In ninth place, trying to remain in the top 10, Yulia Lavrenchuk of Ukraine. The reigning world champion, Michelle Kwan, has arrived in the building. She skates with the leaders in the final group. Welcome back to the World Figure Skating Championships presented by MasterCard. The ladies' free skate taking place. Right now, we take you over to check in with Leslie Visser. Leslie?
Thanks, Terry. A courageous effort today, Nicole. How difficult was it?
It was very difficult. I didn't skate very well, but I was trying really hard, and I just couldn't get under my legs. It's been a real tough 2 days, so I'm just glad that I was able to go out and do the best that I could, and which wasn't that great, but under the circumstances, I made it through.
And what about your gesture at the end? What were you trying to say?
I was just, thanking Carlo that, that all the years he's done and being with me and just everything, and I wanted everyone to know how much I miss him and that I was trying to skate for him, and though it wasn't very well, I tried.
Well, it was a gift to him. Thanks, Nicole. Back to you, Terry.
Leslie, thank you. Obviously, a very difficult week for Nicole Bobek here in her third trip to the World Championships. A difficult free skate for Yulia Lavrenchuk of Ukraine, her technical merit mark. She was in tears as she left the ice, and now her presentation marks. Not happy at all with her appearance here at Worlds.
Julia Lautova, Austria.
Well, here's a young skater who is only 15 years old, but is already the three-time Austrian national champion. In 11th place after the short program, Julia Lautova.
She has a very relaxed style. She almost looks like she skates like in a practice session. She looks so relaxed. Her opening jump is a triple Lutz jump. The preparation, tapping in. Good height, nice rotation in the air.
One of the things about this young lady is that she's really a very cute skater. She's energetic, she's young, she's immature. She looks and skates like a 15-year-old.
I think her body is very well proportioned for skating. Gives a beautiful line out there. She has good technique on her jumps, rotates very straight in the air.
By looking and skating like a 15-year-old now, it means that she might grow into a very accomplished skater. She certainly has the athletic ability and the line, the potential line for that.
It's nice and straight in the air, triple salchow, a little trouble on the landing, but it was clean. Double the 4-minute program made it look very easy.
You have a lot of energy when you're 15, don't you?
She looks very happy with herself.
She missed all of last year with a fractured right leg, so this is a comeback year. And what a year. Strong early success throughout the season and hoping to finish in the top 10 here at the World Championships. Yulia Lautova of Austria. Well, still to skate, the U.S. champion, the leader after the short program, and the favorite here, Tara Lipinski.
We'll be right back.
Figure Skating Championships presented by MasterCard. This special edition of ABC's Wide World of Sports brought to you by MasterCard. MasterCard, the official card of the World Figure Skating Championships. New Spin Fresh, fresh from Glade, SC Johnson Wax. And a whole new Hyundai. Driving is believing. We'll return after this from our ABC stations. You're watching the World Figure Skating Championships presented by MasterCard.
In her last trip to the World Championships in 1995, she finished in 31st place. Yulia Laotova of Austria, much better finish on hand this year.
And here's a look at one of the jumps she did very successfully in the program, a triple flip. Nice height, nice controlled landing, made it look very easy.
It's sort of nice watching her grow up sort of the way she should be.
First set of marks for technical merit. There you see them there. A range of 5.4 up to 5.6. This is a solid showing for her at Worlds. 5.3 up to 5.5. The range for presentation. She's in second place in terms of those that have skated. And now the first of our leaders will take the ice. Here at the World Figure Skating Championships presented by MasterCard, the ladies free skate continuing at the Mallet Ice Center in Lausanne, Switzerland. And in a competition where we have seen a number of faces that are relatively unknown near the top of the leaderboard, this is maybe the biggest surprise of the event. Vanessa Guzmaroli of France in second place after the short program. She can control her own destiny. Remember, if you're in the top three heading into the free skate, and you win that portion of the event, you are the overall winner.
She's skating to the music. Great circus orchestra. There's a lot of character in this choreography and a lot of moves that are referring to the circus. Very entertaining number. Opening with a triple flip. Two-footed the landing.
She may gain some strength with this crowd, though. Remember, we're not far from the French border, and there are a lot of French fans here at the Mallet Ice Center.
Oh, nice. Triple Lutz. Good spring.
Remember, the other top skaters still to come. Tara Lipinski, the leader after the short program, will skate next. Michelle Kwan in fourth place has yet to skate. She follows Maria Butyrskaya, who is currently in third place. And Irina Slutskaya, the European champion. She will skate last.
Intended to be a triple loop, and she doubled that.
One of the things that makes her jump so well is that quick, tight spin. The ability to spin in the air quickly, tightly, completely. Without it, it's disaster.
Vanessa Guzmaroli has never been in this situation before at a world championship. European Championships this year. Like here in Lausanne, she had a tremendous short program, but fell from third to sixth after her free skate.
She choked.
Another way to put it.
She's not choking today. That was a very neat, clean jump. Did you see how tight the revolution was in the air?
very clever number, a lot of animated moves. Here she's playing the character, obviously, of the clown in the circus.
She works with the choreographer, Alan Schramm, who is a very talented skater from the United States. Second generation theatrical skater. He's worked with so many of the French here. He gives them their extra special flair.
Nice triple salchow she just completed.
Combination of moves. Triple loop. Double something or other. What a nice sort of debut for this young lady. Yeah.
She doesn't look real happy though right now. I think she thinks an opportunity is going by the wayside. Vanessa Guzmaroli of France. And coming up next, Tara Lipinski tries to become the youngest ladies champion in world championship history. When she left the ice, she looked very disappointed. Vanessa Guzmaroli of France. Wasn't all that bad, was it?
I got the feeling that she was doing very well.
Well, this was her only real obvious mistake, was her triple flip jump. She had good height, but the landing was two-footed and just could not check out of that landing.
Actually, I think she did quite well, and she should be very proud of herself.
Well, we'll see what the judges.
Alan Schramm on her left.
Technical merit marks, those the best that we've seen so far.
5-6, 5-5, second mark, 5-7, 5-6, 5-6.
See, those are quite commendable.
And the presentation marks, and that makes Vanessa Guzmaroli the leader when you talk about those that have already skated in the free skate. Up next, the leader, Tara Lipinski. She is on a meteoric rise, but to Tara and her family, it's all just part of the plan. Brent Musburger takes an up-close and personal look at the making of a champion.
And there is one skater left to compete.
On February 15, 1997, the stage was set for young Tara Lipinski to make history. Michelle Kwan had suffered through a lackluster performance, leaving the door open and the pressure on the 14-year-old skater.
The triple loop, triple loop. The most difficult combination that any of the women are attempting.
She held on with the concentration, and this is the final move, running camel spin. Now watch the rest of this.
And this audience
already on its feet.
How wonderful. Oh, good for her.
Oh, my. Oh, my.
Yeah, that was such a big relief after, you know, I landed, you know, all the triple-triple and all my jumps. And once I got off, I was just so happy. And once I won, you know, I was so shocked, you know, like it didn't hit me yet, and I just couldn't believe it.
Tara shared with us the raw emotions of a teenage girl. She had arrived, and clearly way ahead of schedule. She was a roller skater at age 3. An ice skater at age 6, and a club champion by age 9, and had already decided on a career path by age 12.
Well, my biggest dream is to win the Olympics.
As a 12-year-old, Tara put herself on the map by winning the U.S. Olympic Festival. Suddenly, skating had a new star, and anywhere that Tara went, the media was sure to follow. We have watched the success story that was Tara Mania, but we didn't see the sacrifices that Tara and her family have endured to get there. In search of the top-notch coaching necessary to succeed on this level, Tara's family made a huge sacrifice.
Well, I have to live away from my dad, He lives in Houston, and my four dogs are there. And I think that's the biggest thing, you know, my dad not being there every night.
In pursuit of her Olympic dream, Tara must eat, drink, and sleep skating 24 hours a day.
She has to be really disciplined. You know, she has to know that, okay, my day starts at 9 o'clock and I really have to work and I have to work hard. And if I slack off, it's not going to be there for me the way I want it.
Tara's dream is the engine that drives the machine. At the heart of Tara's support system is her mother, Pat, who attends every practice. There are also the tutors, the trainers, the costumers, and the coaches all working in sync to help Tara realize her goal.
Let's just do it. Let me see a triple toe. Legs straight in the air.
I see her looking at champions, and you can see it in her eyes if she wants to be that person someday.
Having already beaten Michelle Kwan at both the Nationals and the Champions Series, could Tara's time be now? Will she reach Nagano as an Olympic hopeful or the defending world champion?
On the glass, on the ice, Tara Lipinski, United States of America.
Just part of the plan, this meteoric rise. And here she is trying to become the youngest ladies champion ever.
The music, front the soundtrack, Sense and Sensibility, and Much Ado About Nothing.
Well, Michelle has opened the door once again for Tara. And the question is, will Tara step through and seize the moment the way she did at the Nationals?
Such a straight edge. Body in perfect position there.
Now her first jump combination. She has planned as a triple Lutz, double loop combination.
Watch right here, the height of the free leg.
Triple Lutz, double toe combination. Very solid.
She really almost hammers the foot into the ice there, but it was just fine.
And she has such fun doing all of this. That smile on her face, she looks very relaxed.
When she arrived today with her bag, it looked like she was arriving to a slumber party. And she always has that smile on her face and it seems oblivious to all the pressure around her.
I mean, she is just really doing.
Well, she is the first female skater ever to land this difficult jump combination in a world championship.
So, isn't it wonderful to be 14?
Lots. with a very big smile on her face.
Combination, jumps, sequence, first.
Double axel, half loop, triple salchow. And her last triple planned in this 4-minute program, a triple toe. Very solid.
Sonia Hedy's name may be moved aside in the record book. 14-year-old Tara Lipinski bidding to become the youngest ladies champion in history.
What a gladiatress. She is something.
Oh, everything else is awesome. Let's go. Enjoy it.
Tara Lipinski alongside her coach, Richard Callahan. What a performance, isn't it?
And look at this slow motion. First, the triple Lutz double toe loop. Look at that high bang there, stomp into the ground. A beautiful revolution, turning, the free leg just steps right back. But look at this, a back outside edge into a triple loop, 1 foot. Now she lands and holds the edge and doesn't allow it to continue rotating until she's ready to jump up into the second one. Only done by her, the first time that's been done in this competition.
And you look at her marks for technical merit, they're very high. Elvis Stoico the other night with the quadruple toe, triple toe combination, first time that was done. And now Tara with some history, and for presentation, high as well. And every judge has her right now in first place.
Kristina Jackal Ungar.
And here is 18-year-old Kristina Zacco of Hungary. She's had a terrific season, but not many expected her to be in the final group of skaters at the World Championships. She finished out of the top 10 in 11th place a year ago in Edmonton.
Well, this is a very creative number to the movie soundtrack of the Addams Family. The costume's very clever. Down to the thing on her shoulder, red shaped thing on her her left shoulder. Very solid double axel.
The thing to watch about her jumping is the spring that she gets, the lift into the air. Look at that. Both times. Wonderful spring. And the fact that that was a triple flip, triple toe loop made it extremely difficult and worthy of good marks. Again, the spring is marvelous.
She was in fifth place after the short program. It's a long way to go for her, but certainly a very realistic chance of medaling. Even though she's never been in this elite group of skaters at the world level before, she did capture a silver medal at the Europeans this year. Trying to prove that is no fluke.
Very interesting layback position. Very much the character of this music.
She studies with both her mother and father.
Clever number, though.
It just wasn't her night tonight.
No, it wasn't.
Her performance at the European Championship, brilliant. Tonight, less so.
Kristina Szatko in fifth after the short program, trying to move up. And skating next, the four-time Russian champion. She's in third place after the short. Maria Butyrskaya takes the ice when we come back. Kristina Szatko of Hungary. That's her father, George, who skated against her own Dick Button a few years ago. Yeah. Her marks for technical merit.
Very interesting. He's a retired engineer. He teaches her and works with her on her skating.
Made her first pair of skates, as a matter of fact, by hand. Presentation marks, and Kristina Szatko is now in fourth place in terms of those that have already skated tonight. Here's 24-year-old Maria Butyrskaya of Russia. Earlier this season, she won her fourth Russian national championship, and she just will not go away. She has felt at times the Russian Federation will not support her. She has felt out there all alone, but she is still near the top, and she has a very real chance of winning the gold medal over Tara Lipinski. It would take a great performance here, but she is in third place. And no Russian or Soviet skater has ever won the ladies' gold medal at the World Championships.
Maria is skating to Melaguena. There's a very cool, sophisticated quality to her. This is also the same program as she competed with last year at the Worlds. So she knows this program very well.
That was a tap out of the first triple flip. Double lutz. There's always a kind of slight jerkiness to her landing. There's a wobbly landing position. It almost appears as if she's unsure of her edging. Although that one as smooth as it could be. Compare this to Nicole Bobek, and there's no comparison at all.
Oh, you're right. Nicole has incredible extension. But Maria sets a very exotic tone out here on the ice. Very mature.
It's also so interesting to think about 24-year-old Maria Butyrskaya in the same event as 14-year-old Tara Lipinski and how so different they are.
Triple toe, double toe combination. Intended to be a double axel and she singled that, but she tried it again and did the double. That shows her determination.
Ooh. It was sort of off a little bit at the end. It didn't quite end with the flare and zing that it should have. And I think that coupled with the fact that she gives the impression of being an unsure skater is going to hurt her somewhat. Remember that she's in third place now, and I think she's got a tough time to pull up, certainly against
was
Tara
not one
Lipinski.
Of her best performances.
Nope.
24-year-old Maria Butyrskaya of Russia at least trying to stay in the top three and get a medal here in Lausanne. Coming up next, the reigning world champion Michelle Kwan after this from our ABC stations.
Watching the World Figure Skating Championships presented by MasterCard.
Tara Lipinski waiting around to see if her performance is worthy of the gold medal. Maria Butyrskaya now waiting for her marks.
And this set the tone of Maria's program, this opening triple combination, triple flip, double toe combination. It was not her best performance tonight. I think she's real disappointed.
She sometimes lands as though she's almost on a stiff leg mm-hmm. and causes the other leg to swing around. It removes any sense of beauty from it.
Michelle Kwan will skate next.
I will say some of the moves that she had in her practice were really gorgeous.
Mm-hmm. And Maria up to take a look at her marks, and now not going to wait for the rest of them. Technical merit scores, and those for presentation, and that drops her into third place behind Vanessa Guzmaroli at this point.
5-8, 5-7, thank you.
Michelle Kwan getting ready. She thought she had found the perspective she needed to succeed here, maybe win. Brent Musburger takes us up close and personal with the world champion.
What do you do? The world says you're unbeatable and you skate as if you believe this is true. Until finally, the pressure to be the best overwhelms your confidence and you fall from the great height you have scaled. Do you get angry? Do you give up? Well, if you're Michelle Kwan, you get perspective.
I totally forgot how to have fun before nationals. It was a dreadful time for me because it was like, I focused on the wrong thing. I was thinking of winning and just, okay, I've got to do this. You know, if this doesn't happen, things are going to go really bad. It seemed like I had something to lose, more to lose than to gain. And when I was in nationals, I didn't have the guts. And of course, there's no glory.
Only 2 weeks after relinquishing her national title, Michelle found further proof that she is not invincible. Competing at the Champion Series in Canada, she placed second once again. Looking back, it is clear that it was fear that stood in her way.
Well, at nationals, I wasn't fearless. There was no doubt about it. I was afraid of something, that I had like a monster on the other side. And at that point, I was eaten by the monster. It didn't feel like I was ready. Even though I was physically ready and well-trained and all that, my mind, it was smoking. It was on fire. And I couldn't really put it out at that point.
But Michelle now realizes that she is not doomed to repeat her past. If she can learn to confront her fears of failure head on.
Fear is not something you can hide away from. During my down slope, I was going through not wanting to hear about negative. Now it's much looser. I mean, I could talk about a lot of things, and I'm really open about how my skating is going and stuff. Having bad performances, it always occurs to me that it's like a broken record that replays and replays and replays. I think that's good in a way, that I can fix it and make that broken record be a good one.
Now a year after winning her first world title, Michelle has come full circle. Once again, she will have to prove that she is indeed worthy of the championship. But in Michelle's mind, she's already won the battle against herself.
The one who wins all the time is great, is powerful, but the one who's been trampled on and fallen and injured and is able to get back up and stand up and fight, I mean, that's who I admire the most.
Michelle Kwan, United States of America.
When she arrived here in Lausanne, she figured she had all the problems worked out. She seemed very confident, but then was devastated after her performance in the short program. She is in fourth place, though. And trying to move up, Tara Lipinski is now at the top.
Her coach, Frank Carroll, has told Michelle to attack, don't defend. And that's exactly what she needs to do tonight.
Sets her apart is the really beautiful line and maturity that she has. Just watch this. It's lovely.
Opening combination, the triple lutz double toe combination. Reaching back. Oh. Very solid. Triple combination, which she fell on at the Nationals. Triple toe. Triple toe.
Not this time.
Triple flip jump. Perfectly neat and clean. This is going to be a tough decision if she skates this beautifully all the way through.
The problem with being in fourth, though, is that you don't control your own destiny. You need help from other skaters. And there's only one left, Irina Slutskaya. And
she is in sixth place.
Nice, crisp moves to it. Nice interpretation of this music.
To see that she has pulled herself back up and skated without mistake.
She skated with inspiration again tonight, I think.
I think what a victory that is for her.
A bit of redemption for Michelle Kwan, no matter what happens with the judges.
I mean, the fact that she just was able to overcome all of those mistakes and all of that pressure is just really sensational for her.
The last time the U.S. had two women on the world podium, 1992. Christy Yamaguchi, Nancy Kerrigan. Frank Carroll, her coach, congratulating her. Tara Lipinski waiting around to see if she will retain the lead. Michelle Kwan out of breath, but very happy after her free skate.
And look at this. Very, very neat and clean triple toe loop, triple toe loop. You can't ask for better than that. And this, her triple loop jump, really beautiful, neat, clean.
Well, with all that she went through in the last, well, month and a half, the loss at Nationals, and then feeling that she really had gotten it back together emotionally, all her confidence, she came here very confident in Lausanne, and then what happened in the short program. This is a performance that's obviously very important to her. You gotta be happy for her.
Yes, I am extremely proud of her, and I think these are good lessons for her in preparation for Nagano.
The Olympics next year in Japan. Technical merit marks.
There they are, very, very high.
Even higher for presentation, and you see the judges' placements. Michelle Kwan now in second place behind, there she is, Tara Lipinski. But in terms of those placements, remember, that's just for the free skate. So that could change depending on what happens with the last skater of the evening. And here is the European champion, Irina Slutskaya, 18 years old. She became the first Russian or Soviet woman ever to win the European title a year ago. And remember, she was injured during the practice this morning. If you were with us earlier, you saw her hit the boards very hard. There was a question as to whether she would even skate in this free skate. But here she is. And during the warm-up, she looked physically to be fine.
She was doing all of her jumps. At this point in her career, Irina's only true strengths right now are her jumps. I think she desperately needs to improve on her artistry.
The music, Phantom on Ice.
And this is the opening jump triple Lutz double toe that she fell on in the short program.
Ooh. Oh. Forced that one through.
Yes. Triple Salchow, triple loop combination.
Good height on it.
Yes.
Good berry.
Slutskaya in sixth place. Hopes of winning may not be there, but certainly a medal in mind. And remember how the judges place her performance certainly can affect the top part of the standings.
When I was talking about her artistry earlier, look how she's skating around. She needs to hold her back up straighter, much better posture. Beautiful triple loop.
Back was up nicely there.
Mm-hmm. And speaking of a straight back, the back injury, no real signs of that so far in this performance.
Something really interesting can happen here. Between Lipinski and Kwan, Kwan had the most number of firsts, a majority of firsts in the free program alone. Now, if this performance, because it was complete and there were no major mistakes, upsets that balance, it could switch the position between Lipinski and Kwan.
We'll see what happens to Irina Slutskaya, and also to the top of the leaderboard, this ever-present smile and relaxed attitude of Tara Lipinski. But We will have to wait to find out if she becomes the youngest ladies champion in history. We'll do that when we return.
It was an unforgettable season. Michelle Kwan's breathtaking rise to the pinnacle of figure skating. Todd Eldridge's world-conquering performance. Rudy Galindo's personal triumph. Call 1-800-4-ABC-VCR to order Magic Memories on Ice 3, an unforgettable season. On this exclusive video from ABC Sports, Jim McKay hosts the greatest moments from the 1996 U.S., European, and World Championships. Call 1-800-4-ABC-VCR to order, only $19.95 plus $3.95 shipping.
As Yogi said, it ain't over till it's over. Never more true than right now. Irina Slutskaya, the final skater of the evening, waiting for her scores right now. She can shake up the entire leaderboard depending on how the judges place her. Technical merit marks, pretty solid.
See, judge number four and judge number five made a switch on the free program alone, putting her in first place, along with judge number nine.
And the marks for presentation, good enough to place her in fourth, but Tara Lipinski is the world champion. She finishes ahead of Michelle Kwan and then Vanessa Guzmaroli. Right now, Leslie Visser is with the youngest ladies world champion in history.
Terry, she's come a long way from a roller rink in South Jersey. Congratulations, world champion. How does that sound?
It's amazing. Right now, I think I'm still in shock like I was at Nationals, you know, but it's great. I love it.
What do you think went really well? What did you feel real good about out there tonight?
Everything felt just in place, and after the short being in first, I was a little nervous, and I really handled it well, so I was excited.
You know, you were 15th last year. Did you ever imagine, how do you think you got here?
I just think hard work and confidence is a big thing.
And on to Nagano?
Hopefully. It's my big dream.
It's great. What about being the youngest? Sonia Henie, when did you first hear of her?
Well, I've known of her, not a lot, though, but being the youngest is a great accomplishment. I mean, it makes a record, but I think whatever age you are, you're happy with what you get.
Well, it was tremendous. She wears a necklace that says, short, what to show them, short but good?
Yes.
They might have to change that to short but great. Congratulations. Back to you, Terry.
Leslie, short but the best may be more accurate this week. Tara and Michelle, the first American duo on the world podium since 1992. The best finish ever for Vanessa Guzmaroli at the World Championships. Obviously a tough week for Nicole Bobek, finishing in 13th. You got to admire the way Michelle finished. She's with Leslie.
Terry, she has always said the bigger the challenge, the harder she works, and it showed tonight. You had to feel good about tonight, Michelle.
Well, I really did. I mean, I went out there and said, okay, this is it. And I knew I worked all year for this, and kind of boils down to one thing.
You had always said the only person that would beat you is yourself, but do you think you had a real jump in confidence tonight?
I really did. I mean, you know what? To tell you the truth, it's like the only time I've enjoyed skating this year is the Worlds. I mean, I had a lot of pressure put on by myself, and now it's kind of like this is nothing. I mean, you look at it's not life and death, and kind of put it in perspective, and it's only a competition.
Frank said you actually thought about Scott Hamilton before you went out.
Well, I heard about the news, and I was really upset, and I kind of put it like nothing really matters. I mean, we're here to skate. That's it. It's not like I'm going to die if I got second.
Well, you did a beautiful job.
Thank you.
Back to you, Terry.
The perspective of Michelle Kwan. Tara Lipinski on a run that just continues. Two Americans atop the world podium, and Brent Musburger's final thoughts on what it's like to be a 14-year-old with your own slogan when we come back.
The World Figure Skating Championships presented by MasterCard. This special edition of ABC's Wide World of Sports brought to you by MasterCard. MasterCard, the official card of the World Figure Skating Championships. Transitions Lenses. It's a new day in eye care with Transitions Lenses. And a whole new Hyundai. Driving is believing.
Mesdames, Mesdemoiselles, Messieurs, l'hymne des États-Unis d'Amérique.
Ladies and gentlemen, the national anthem of the United States of America.
Thank you.
Well, Michelle was referring to the former champion, Scott Hamilton, who unfortunately is battling cancer. But in case you have not heard, the prognosis is good for a complete recovery, and all of us certainly wish Scott nothing but the best. And wasn't Michelle beautiful tonight to defend her championship in that manner when she knew there was very little chance that she could win? Because, you know, this was not so much a competition today as it was a coronation for Tara Lipinski. She is our newest ice princess, the youngest ever, and likely to remain so forever. The international rule next year says you must be 15 years old by July 1st on the previous year to compete in the Worlds. But by then, Tara will be the defending world champion. You know, she reminds me somewhat of an elfin gymnast from the old Soviet Union by the name of Olga Korbut. And already, Tara is attracting worldwide headlines, just like Olga did. Today, in a snobbish put-down, the London, England Times, in a sports column, said that Tara's not spectacular, just small, which gives her an enormous and unfair advantage. How cruel. Tara Lipinski skated beautifully through the pressures of this week. And if Sonja Henie can be a young champion, why not Tara Lipinski? You know, being a champion is about handling the pressure of the world stage, and that's what Tara did. And we'll see her debut as the reigning world champion this Thursday night in a special edition of ABC's Wide World of Sports. We'll have special performances for the 1997 World Figure Skating Championships presented by MasterCard, beginning at 8 p.m. Eastern and Pacific, 7 Central, right here on ABC Sports. For all of us at ABC Sports, I'm Brett Musburger wishing you a very good evening from Lausanne, Switzerland.